You got a problem with me, you know my slogan, nigga, go get that gun. Oh, shit. Oh, yeah. Okay, y'all got...
Shout out to all the yo-yas on the east side. It's your boy KD. Make sure you like that video. Subscribe to the channel. Let's get into it. Now, last night was the versus between the Lox and Dipset. And let's just say, the Lox just outclassed Dipset in every single way. Now that versus is being done on stage in front of a crowd, I feel like things have definitely changed. If you're not performing up to a certain standard, you're not gonna be able to win that crowd over. And that's exactly what the Lox did last night. If you look at the list of the songs that were performed, the Lox literally was beating out Dipset with freestyles. The whole time Dipset was performing, they were performing with the track playing in the background. All the Lox needed was the beat, and they was just rapping. That's literally all it came out to. And Jadakiss, yo, just leave Jadakiss alone when it comes to this versus shit. We all saw what he did to Fab. Now you can technically say he single-handedly took out Dipset. And that's not no easy feat. Dipset was not moving unified yesterday. They look like they haven't seen each other in a while, and they just got together this day to get a bag. The Lox were moving together like they've been inseparable for years, and that's exactly what it is. I feel like we've never seen the Lox even have a public fallout. The Diplomats, on the other hand, have had their share of drama between each other. You can just tell that the Lox's chemistry was impeccable. They really didn't have a strategy like the Lox did. The Lox came prepared to put on a show. The shit talking was at 100. Dipset really couldn't keep up. When it comes to that mic presence, Jadakiss is probably top one when it comes to that mic presence. He's the definition of an MC. Cameron tried to put on a freestyle towards the end, but after what we just saw Jadakiss do, there was no way he was getting that off. This really opens up the conversation about how important being a great performer is. When you get on that stage, I see a lot of rappers nowadays, they just perform with the track playing on the background, but it really does make a difference when you perform, just have the beat playing, and you're giving the fans an actual show. And I feel like Dipset was trying to take the easy route, and it really didn't end up working out for them at the end. Yes, Dipset has a lot of hits, but now with the crowd being presented in verses, you gotta put on a show and win that crowd over at the same time. And that's what you call talent. Man, Jadakiss even took off Juelz's bandana. I was so, yo, I was screaming at my TV, yo. It was a long night for me, y'all. I was stressed out last night. Stressed out. And it's kind of crazy that a lot, I'm not going to say a majority of people, but a lot of people were counting out the Lox, saying that, yo, this is going to be an easy victory for Dipset. But like I told people in my comment section, the Lox is nothing to sleep on. All in all, this was a great versus. Probably my favorite so far. It was dope how they had Bruce Buffer at the beginning. They couldn't even let him get his words off because they was coming at each other back and forth. Great night for New York City. One of the best verses I've seen. And at the end of the day, both crews got to show out. It's just the Lox came to show out a little bit more. But y'all let me know what y'all think, man. How do you guys feel about the verses? How do you guys feel about Jadakiss's performance? I think Jadakiss just showed out to the maximum. There's nothing over Jadakiss at this point. When it comes to verses, leave that man alone, man. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure you like, subscribe to the channel. I'm out of here.